CC stands for completion certificate, OC stands for occupation certificate. Now, the first step is the completion certificate. Now, completion certificate you achieve after achieving certain milestones. So, for example, there is a fire NOC, there is the height of the building, so you need an NOC from the airport, and various other NOCs. Once they lead up to that, you are granted a CC. Now, CC, for grant of CC, what has to be considered by the respective authority is that whether the building conforms to the sanction plan, it conforms to the building bylaws, it conforms to all the maps of that entire structure, whether they have been followed in toto or not. So if that is done, then the concerned authority grants a completion certificate, because only upon receipt of completion certificate, then that particular builder or that housing society becomes eligible to apply for water and electricity and sanitation. Because till the time your structure is not complete, you will not be entitled to seek for water and electricity and sanitation, all of that. So once you have that, then you seek an occupancy certificate. Simply, if you go by the word, basically once you're given the occupancy certificate, that means that particular society is ready for occupation. And it does not only talk about the structure, it talks about the access to the structure, such as roads, such as basic infrastructure. Once it has the air, water, electricity, sanitation, all of that it becomes habitable. It is actually livable. And it has the basic amount of access to reach that particular property. So in a layman's language, completion certificate talks about that particular structure, whether that structure is complete. Occupancy certificate, simply speaking, is when it is fit for occupation. That means for a layman person, one who has access by his car, who can walk up to his, it can be a structure which is complete, but it's in the middle of nowhere. So it has CC, but one can't live there because, the basic civic infrastructure is not there. The roads are not there. So once you have an OC, that means the basic civic facilities are also in place, and only then you are granted an OC. It's the builder's responsibility, A, to meet the deadline what he's given in the builder buyer agreement. Now, we have all noticed every second person has had a horrible experience because the project is mostly delayed and not, going on time. Now, in that situation, the OC, once it is granted, it is a publicly available document, and the agreement, builder buyer agreement, provides that in a certain stipulated time period, they have to complete the project. So if they have not done so and they have not obtained the OC, then obviously the builder becomes liable for paying delayed possession charges. But it is never the responsibility of the buyer to see whether it is done or not. Different states have different laws. There is a concept in UP and Gurgaon. If we talk about these two states, there is a concept of part OC and part CC, wherein the sanction plan was divided into certain parts. Maybe, the society may have about 20 towers, but it has different sanction plans, and on that basis 5 towers are ready, because sometimes builder also wants to rotate the money, they want the money to come in, 5 projects are ready, and use that money to invest in the remaining of the entire housing project. So it actually depends on how they have sought the initial sanctioned plan of the entire particular area. So in that case, if it is a part of the entire society which is complete under UP as well as Haryana, both the respective states have a concept of part OC. There are many instances that despite builder obtaining OC and CC, once the actual buyer who goes and wants to use his house and flat or whatever, he finds that there are many lackings, that it is still not complete or not ideal or not what was promised to them. In that eventuality, two situations arise. Firstly, in all likelihood that the authority which granted them the OC did not do its due diligence properly, if that could be the case, or B, there is that it did its due diligence. However, what was promised under the agreement was much more. That is the builder buyer agreement. So we have well within our right to approach the authority which granted the OC, to question them and to tell them that their OC be revoked because XYZ formalities are not, because it's a simple checklist with the authority. They have to see water, they have to see electricity, they have to see sanitation, they have to see walking ways, the width of the road, whether it's enough, whether it's matching the sanction plan, all of that, and the access outside, all of those things. So if that is the case, then they are well within the right to approach the authority to seek revocation of the OC, A. B, if the OC is in place, however, what was promised under the agreement was much more than the basic requirement of OC. The litigants have the right of approaching the respective consumer forum or the RERA authority for their remedy, saying that, somebody can say that I had paid a premium for a view which was of the park or which was of some pond or, some scenic view, and I was not promised that. And therefore, for that reason, I had paid a premium also. So he's well within his right to approach the either of the authorities, which is the RERA or the consumer forum, and rake up these issues. So the timeline is there. So builder has to mandatorily comply with the set guidelines and timelines. But if he has not done so, we are well within our right to seek our money back or ask them to give us delayed possession charges, because it is a settled law both before RERA as well as the consumer forum that one can approach the court if the time provided by the builder has not been met.
Please like and share this video and do subscribe to MBTV.